There we go, that should fix it. I hope. I guess we should start with some connection tests. So let's just do that and be done with it, I guess. So let's go, give it a shot. And let's go see, make sure that my connection holds up. Now, if anyone's asking, why the fuck are you playing a tier 2 tank? I test my connection with low tier tanks because I would feel absolutely horrible if I ruined a good game or threw away a times 2 with absolutely horrible, unplayable connection. The weather is really bad right now. And I'm nowhere near the hurricane. This is just lakefront weather, and it's absolutely horrible. But yeah. So, yeah, stream was late today also because I had to go out in that horrible weather. In fact, I didn't even get to finish my lunch. We were just sat down to eat. And all of a sudden, it was the secretary came in and was like, hey, we need you guys to go back out. Dispatch is going absolutely apeshit. And there's a tree across the road on lines on both sides of the road. So you need to go and deal with it. So yeah, we had to get State Electric Company out there. Our own city trucks were, we had to get both city trucks out. Okay, so this guy is, wants to be that guy. I really do hate assholes that are just like, hey, do you like just ramming? I don't like ramming. Goodbye. You want to get killed? That's fine. Ready to fire. The frickin' BT2 likes ramming. PlayStation guy also likes ramming. That's excellent. Ready to fire on target. This guy, I swear. My audio is not synced up. That is a fact. Hold on, let me double check this. Look at this, I have no audio. It's just my stats. And it's just my stats for those that care. If you have no idea what it is, then don't bother yourself. You're just gonna be in a world of frustration and hurt. Dude, I have like no audio. The enemy knows our location. Nope, dead. Dude, I have no idea what's going on. I like full connection, or showing full connection, but like my audio is so desynchronized. I hope that's not it. Otherwise, I hope that's a fixable issue, because this is just bad. This isn't even stream stuff. This is coming through my... That's coming through my Xbox, I think, too. My speakers. But my connection's holding up, so I think we can move up to higher tiers. Now, you know, everyone voted on the Grille 15. So, or the winner of that little vote was the Grille 15. So, I want to play it tonight, because I haven't touched it since I bought it. And I'm just going to kind of wait till more people show up right now. Otherwise, I'm just going to kind of chill. I'm pretty tired. I've literally been out in the shitstorm rain thing that's been going on nonstop for like the past since noon. How are you? Yeah, I can't speak. I'm so tired. How are you doing, Voldemort? What's going on? But yeah, as you can see, I also am not in my usual polo attire. I am in a hoodie and my sweatpants. Why? Because being cold, miserable, and soaking wet for like 6 hours is not fun. And I just want to be warm and cozy, and I just don't care. Tier 9 game, okay. Oh nice, you just got back from a holiday? That's sweet. Where'd you go and how was it? Well, vacations tend to kind of burn you out in every aspect that you can think of, and yeah, they are always tired. I think we can all agree on that. I will just get lit up by some. Nope. I'm content to sit here. Why am I content to sit here? Because A, I'm a TD. I have not seen one of those in God knows how long. Good job, guys. We have not even bothered to defend. Oh, are you kidding me? Fully aimed in and nothing? Sup, Jacek? to go. I'm gonna move up. Maybe I don't, based on the fact that there's a lot of people over here. Locked on.
Like that one went right through. Ready to fire. Penetration. All our artillery has been destroyed.
What is your end? Like, what do you mean? Dude, this mouse shouldn't just get in my way. I gotta run. Yeah, currently I'm holding up and the stream is not changing for me. Normally I feel the effects before you guys do, so I think it might just be your internet. But again, I'd like to point out that it may even be me, because I'm streaming in what you could almost kind of consider like a typhoon, but it's not even a typhoon. Light tank needs to do his damn job. You're a 1390. Unless you're reloading, I don't want to see this coward shit. Let this light tank deal with this shit, because this is annoying. I have this stupid ad going on. I don't care about burning cardio net. I can see why people get ad blocker. Oh, thanks guys. Thanks, like honest to God, just. Light tank has done absolutely jack shit. Light tank has had seriously one fucking job, and that was to deal with the other light tank. Everyone else could do it, but no. The full health 1390 was too scared. I'm sorry, I'm not in the mood or even the frame of mind to be like, oh, there's some ulterior motive. No, do your damn job. Like, we're going to lose because the 1390 is letting the T-49 run amok and just blap everyone. Jacek, I don't have a favorite premium tank. Pretty much any tank that I 3-mark, I enjoy. Yeah, and just because... ha! Shoot! Oh my god. Yep, there we go. Serves the little shit right. I'm feeling incredibly toxic. I think last time I got really toxic. I had to set aside and just be like, I can't stream for a little bit. I gotta cool off, chill out. But, you know, I think it's understandable when you've literally been out in a downpour rain for like 6 hours that you're like, and you didn't even get to finish your damn lunch. Yeah, I think I hope many people can understand that I'm really just like not in like the mood to deal with idiocy. But I got the high caliber. I'll take the high caliber. I did 4.5K combined. How it's a class 2, I don't know. But hey, I'll take it. At least something looking good. At least something's looking good. How's everyone else doing here? Let me just see. Well, yeah, but that's ranked battles. That's literally ranked battles. The whole thing is, I don't even bother. It's like the absolute selfish of selfish play. And I don't mean that, you know, everyone playing ranked is a selfish player, but the whole way ranked is, it's almost designed to just be to promote selfishness, because it's like, if your team loses, unless you're at the top of that leaderboard, you're going to like lose points. I think that's how it is. You lose points if you lose and you're not at the top of the leaderboard. Whereas if you win, you all get points. So, you know, the thing to play to the best of your abilities and to literally sabotage everyone else on your team in order to make sure you are at the top, win or lose, you get the most points or don't lose any points. It's just selfish gameplay. Just selfish gameplay. Or selfish attitudes. I don't know how to word it. I'm just like kind of on the ropes here of like, I probably need two of these and I only had one. Yeah, well, my poncho soaked right through. Gloves, you could literally wring out. Pants wet, shirt underneath the poncho wet, hat wet, hard hat, rim of water every time I had to take it off. Covered in wood chippings, you know, having to deal with the fact that we're trying to cut to clear the road while still having to deal with a live wire that none of us realized was live until we heard humming. And they're like, oh shit. So, yeah. And then the state electric company came out and got that fixed, and then we're all like, yep, alright, time to haul ass and get this shit done. Alrighty, so community voted. I had two polls out. Waffle or grill. I actually did hard math and figured out the exact number of people that voted. Apparently there's like 0.7% of one person voted. I don't understand how you can only vote count as 0.7 of one vote. I don't understand how that works. I really don't. I no idea. So winner was the Grill 15 by no joke 4 votes. So I have the grill. I'm going to take a little bit of a break from the off pan Sophia. And we will revisit the offhand Sophia and try and get to the waffle at a later time. So, and I've been holding off on playing this since I bought it, because I wanted to experience this playing this tank for the first time with you all. So, today probably wasn't really the best day to even bother, but, you know. You know what? I've kind of been looking forward to playing this and experiencing it with everyone, so. Cold, rain, shitty attitude. Who cares? Let's do it. But yes, Jacek, this is my newest tier 10. I don't even know what the hell number this one is. But for everyone just joining me, how are you doing on this wonderful Friday? Hopefully, you're not dealing with what essentially is a goddamn typhoon and you're nowhere near the hurricane. Hopefully your guys' days are going better. Oh, you know, Medved, dude, like, I can handle pants being wet, chafing me. You know, I can handle that. When I'm prepared to get wet, it's all right. I've accepted the fact I'm going to get wet. I don't like it when magically all of a sudden I'm wet. But oh my god, the moment water gets in my shoes, oh shit, dude, my attitude is just immediately pissy. Which it did. Water got in my boots. My boots are like literally 6 years old, and if I'm dealing with asphalt and everything like that, they're just torn to shit. There's no need to push me. Plenty fast enough as it is. Do you see me? I'm fast as fuck. So, yeah. But, yeah, that's it for me. David Blaine Ascension, because YouTube ads have to literally annoy me. Alright. So, yeah, I get... I'm detected? What is... I have like 800 bushes in front of me and a camo net. Yep. Literally that pisses me off already. Are you fucking kidding me? Yeah, what is this? Yeah, no. Oh, 57 heavy in front of me. Yep, there it is. Mechanics at its goddamn finest. Camo net and like 12 fucking bushes in front of me, and apparently that doesn't mean jack shit. Am I not able to rotate? Jesus. I thought I could. Oh, that doesn't decrease my view range by anything. Oh my god. Target locked. Oh shit, dude, he's in my detection range. Fuck that. I'm out. Yeah, I think I got, like, some sawdust or something in my nose. Oh my god. It was a big tree. I wish it was Saturday already. I wish that means I could sleep. Horrible gameplay. I haven't even penned a single fucking shot. Like, what is this shit? Like, I just get detected right away through hard cover. What's up, Alex? Did I say I got detected through hard cover? God damn it. I got detected through, like, what should be working camo. Well, Mace, honest to goodness, this is literally the first game I've played with this thing. And probably my first actual dedicated sniping TD that isn't the Stritzvon. So, yeah, saying that I know how to play this is like me literally saying I know how to have brain surgery, like perform brain surgery. So, yeah. Mace, but this is one of the new revamped maps. Our bushes should be working now. At least on this map.
Ready to fire on target.
What was that? Ah, oh, fuck.
Target locked.
Literally, my best bet is to not shoot, probably. No, well, Mace, it did come off a little bit like that, but... There it is! There it absolutely fucking is. Instead of worrying about the actual flank, we're, you know, doing this shit. I'm gonna do that again. I did 2K actual raw, damn it. Jesus Christ, I'm trimming this fucking mustache, man. I'm sick and tired of beard hairs. Tickling it. God damn. But yeah, no, Mace, you're fine. You're fine. I'm just really not in a super cheery mood at all. But I must continue streaming. I also need to blow my nose, but no, I need to like deep clean my nose. I need to get like one of those like nasal washers. My goodness. See, they're capping out and we're doing jack shit about it. It should definitely have way better camo, but I think it does have horrible camo. I could be wrong. You just literally witnessed the first game of me doing 2K, the equivalent of a waffle, and then just getting killed. But at the same time, you know, what is working concealment? The only other dedicated sniping TD I have is the Stritzvon, but that's it's like practically a class of its own. What to play? Play the Senshi. But yeah, how are you doing, Mace? How you got doing, Alex? I don't remember if I asked you guys. Mace, just rip when you are a little weakly armored TD on any city map. Oh, well, are we back? Does that mean I could potentially redeem myself? We're gonna redeem ourselves. Playing zombies to be chill. I think zombies died with me after. I think it was like Black Ops 2. Black Ops was the zombies for me. Like that was the zombies. I enjoyed that. All the, you know. Yeah, and then they start getting weird with the zombies, and then I'm just like, this is. No. Oh, Mace, why did you open your mouth? Why did you open your mouth, Mace? Not your fault, I guess, Mace. It's not really your fault. Watch, I'm gonna come this way, and there's gonna be no one. No one's gonna go this way. I wanted to try and sneak it. Wondered if I could snake it. Trying to break line of sight on this. Why do I have 15 premium rounds on a TD? Because you could never... You always will need premium rounds for something. good. I almost got detected there. That could have been really bad.
Locked and loaded.
I really want this machine to just make a push. See, I carry a lot of premium rounds on my tanks for various reasons. What's up, Harry Frogger? How you doing? Alright, so I guess real quick, I apparently have to justify my premium rounds here. So, if you watched my how to use or when to use premium rounds vid, I think I cover pretty much all the reasons that I carry premium rounds, and pretty much the main reasons you should carry a healthy amount of premium rounds. One of them is if you're bottom tier and you should always have enough premium rounds to kill the highest health tank you might face. Obviously, I don't have a problem issue with that when I'm a TD at tier 10, so you know that can kind of be canceled out. The other one is, and these are the ones I kind of live by a lot, is if I'm low health, like one shot status, or my gun my loader is dead or something like that, I will always carry enough premium rounds to try and stay in the fight as long as possible, for the sole purpose that every time I poke out, I am at risk of being killed. So I need to make sure that every shot I fire counts. So in that, you know, I get ammo racked, I'm switching to premium rounds, because if I can't repair it, you know, that extra long reload, I need to make sure that my shot isn't wasted. So I'm going to switch to premium rounds so I know that shot will go through majority of the time. If I become a one shot, I got hit by Artie, I'm now at like 12 HP on my tank, I'm switching to premium rounds because I know every time I expose myself, I am risking getting killed. And I'm still a gun in the fight, therefore I need to make sure every shot counts. That's why I always carry a healthy enough amount of premium rounds. Or if I just really need to, like, put on the backpack, which rarely ever happens, then yes, I switch to premium rounds. But J6, see, that's the thing. And not trying to be mean or demeaning here. You know, everyone has their different thought processes, but honestly, I don't give a shit what tank I'm in. I'm loading a healthy amount of premium rounds because I might need them. You know, the grill, you know, I don't know, have never tested it before, but I don't think the grill is going to go through the front turret cheeks of an E100 or a mouse without premium rounds. I don't think, you know, it's going to just go through the lower plate of a Panzer 7 like butter with standard rounds. It's, you know, I will carry the amount of rounds that I need in order to defeat, you know, whatever I need, whatever I may face. That's just my method of thinking right there. And I obviously have the silver to run full premium for God knows how long. But it's just, that is my methodology, is from the competition of do whatever you need to do in order to keep your gun up and in the fight. And that is one of those methods of thinking that separates the really good players from the casual players. Because if you feel you don't need to use premium rounds or whatever it is, then you're going to, you know, the chances are, not saying you are this type of person, but from what I've encountered, those players that are like, you know, have that thinking of, oh, well, I'm in a TD, I don't need premium rounds, then it's like, you, most of the time I end up seeing those are the people that are complaining that a tank they can't pen frontally is OP and needs nerf. Okay. No. the good players are going to utilize every asset they have at their disposal and are going to accept methodologies or mentalities that are pretty much... I'm trying to word things right. That are pretty much required in order to perform well. You know. And you could consider that methodology where it's like, you know, okay... You know, one shot, ammo racked, can't repair it, switch into premium rounds, don't give a shit what I'm in. That type of stuff is pretty much keeping your gun hot, keeping yourself in the fight, and, you know, maintaining being a threat on the battlefield. It's that's healthy thinking there. Loading full prem just because is just because you're that guy. But, you know, having enough to deal with certain situations like that, you know, that takes a good amount of skill to kind of think on that level. Oh, this is... Like, Jason, if I remember correctly, you said you have, like, only, like, two tier 10s, right? Is that it? Because, and again, I'm by no means, please do not take this as stat shaming or something, because that's, A, I'm not going to be bringing up stats. I'm just kind of mentioning, comparing experience here. Compared to your two, I have 46 tier 10s. That number is irrelevant. Don't look at it like I'm comparing that. What I'm trying to get my point across is I have played this game a very long time and have played multiple different types of vehicles against pretty much every tier 10 that you might face. You tend to learn and pick up really quickly, and you also learn this really well in competition too, that standard rounds or anything like that, you know, no. There's times where premium rounds are absolutely necessary by a tank by tank basis, regardless of what you yourself are in. I could be in a Death Star or, you know, the Jaegeru and not need to fire heat because I'm in a Waffle or a Jaegeru or something, but there might be times where I absolutely have to use those. It's just, you know, based on the, like, I have, what, one of every single type of tank, and for the most part, multiple of each nation. You tend to realize that some tanks require full premium. IS-7 is a perfect example of this. This thing is pretty much dog shit compared to everything else, unless you have this. I've run full premium with the exception of 5HE because the gun is a load of shit with AP rounds. It's playable, but it's trash. You tend to know what you need to run the more tanks you play. So you'll get there. You definitely will get there. Just give it time. I have faith you will fully understand my argument on this. But, you know, I'm not going to shove it down your throat. I just know that at some point you'll realize this. And when you realize it, I will have done my job correctly. Oh shit, hit the wrong button. I feel like playing one of the two here. I just kind of looked at these on a whim and I was, yeah, but that's hash. You know, that don't matter if you just splashed or penned, you are dealing damage. I'm going to do this. I'm going to literally just dirt people with a Hetzer gun. I'm going to troll people. Why is it not showing how long I've been up? How long have I been up? Almost an hour. Oh boy, it feels like it's been 2 hours. I think I've been lost to time, boys. Boys, tankers, girls. I mean, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. I can get rid of UPS tracking because my package has been delivered. Now just waiting on USPS and their stupid bullshit because apparently, you know, they're using Hurricane Laura as an excuse to affect service, you know, in the northeast portion of the country, even though Laura's not even goddamn there yet. Freaking package has been in pre-shipment for like the past week. Horrible service.
We've got enemies in the area. Take them down or capture their base.
I'm gonna go right at them. I think this is like supposed to be like the trolliest of the tanks in Mercenaries. I think the hard case is another one of those, but yeah. I feel like literally trolling people in Derping right now. I want to relieve some stress. I do remember a reason why I absolutely hated the AT-2, though. And the obvious reasons is it's like slower than the T-95. Good God. Get, will you quit angling yourself to me, sir? I want to hit you. Or I'll just track you, apparently. So, 105 HE. I have never used the Hetzer gun, so I do not have a whole lot of experience with this gun. I just don't. Forget I'm dealing with a derp gun. I'm not dealing with a standard TD riot round.
Ready to fire. The enemy knows our location. Track repair.
You think you have stopped me, sir, but you have not.
They found us.
Well, I can tell you the moment that I actually get a chance to look. But as it stands right now, I've done absolutely jack shit in this game. Because this thing is like designed to be the trolliest MF-er like in a city environment. Yet in these stupid things and it behaves like a regular AT-2. Ooh, what's this? You can't pen me now? And then Artie just takes it. Okay, cool. Thanks, Artie. Now I'm slowly remembering why I never played this. After, you know, playing like who knows how many games with it. Just immediately like, yep, this sucks. And everyone kills everything before I get there. Doesn't even give me a chance to do anything.
Great job, man.
I did more, got more assisted damage than I actually did damage. Not good. It's also tier 5, so why should I care? It was a mistake playing the long bomb. You know what else was a mistake? This garage. So the Alpha is 350, but 410 for HE. Accuracy is 0.5. Over 0.5, so, you know. Garbage. You know what else would help? Probably having equipment on this, too, other than a goddamn gun rammer. Let's go Kronvon. But yeah, I don't really recommend a whole lot of mercenary tanks to anyone. I'm gonna adjust this so I don't, like, magically yank out my chat cable. And then the next tank I'll play is probably a Death Star. Yes, my anteater face. Frowny anteater face, yes. I can't believe I got suckered into doing that from DP. Good god. No TDs either, so I don't need to worry about death from above. What's up, Jayco? How you doing? Oh, shit. I have to see what you said there. I want to respond.
Ready to fire on target.
But I'm in that current, like, situation here where, you know, obviously now I'm distracted by the fact that everyone behind me can't shoot a fucking Action X that just broadsided himself to you. How blind are you? Of course. I need to get out of here.
Enemy's got us in their sights. Ready to fire. Unlocking target.
Guy needs to fall back, dude. I can't do anything if this guy... Of course. Dude, oh my goodness. Yep, because spaced armor stops 120mm APCR. Yep. Yep. Yep, 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 yep. I have neglected a lot of my tier 10s. No, eat shit. Time to push up.
The enemy knows our location. Loaded and ready. Target locked. Penetration. Best job I ever had.
So, yeah, my, I pretty much, it wasn't directly tied to just rank, it was more just like the philosophy in general, Jayco. But, hey, Jacek, have a good one, man. Thanks for stopping by and, talking and chatting. And have a good weekend as well. But, the, you know, it's more just the philosophy, the ideology of you need to do whatever you can in order to win, in order to perform the best that you can. And it's just that type of mentality that is just a factor in what separates the good, the players that will continuously grow and improve, and those that will just stagnate at a certain stat. Now, if you don't care about stats, by all means, play the way you want. I'm not going to force anything down you. I'll give you a gentle nudge in the right direction in the event that you do want to improve, but I'm not going to shove my, you know, shove opinions and stuff down my down your throat. But if you are looking for improvement, you need to adopt the ideology that you need to do, and you need to do what you need to do. You need to use whatever you need to use, and you need to just accept, you know, you methods that you're not comfortable with. And if you do all three of those, you're going in the right direction of improving yourself as a player in this game. So. Okay. Let's play Death Star. Wonder how many people are going to get mad at me that I have AP rounds loaded on my Death Star. I need to reset my song. Yep, Jayco, I could not agree any more than what you've, I could not agree any more with what you have stated. You know you're tired when you're struggling to make sure your sentence is right and grammatically correct. I'm supposed to go airsofting tomorrow, but I'm looking at this weather and I'm like, yeah, this ain't happening. Becky Lynch got annihilated. Okay.
The enemy is capturing the base. Focus on this area. Enemies are capturing the base.
Your puny round means nothing to me. Yeah, switching to that hash. Especially for that sucker. Okay, that did absolutely less than I thought it was going to do. we go. That's better. Yeah, he quickly realized, oh shit. Fucking buildings, dude. They always ruin my shots. They're already dead.
Ready to fire on target. We're capturing the base.
I'm not the best Death Star player, but I do feel like I could probably hold my own reasonably comfortably. She's not going to do anything to that guy. How long have I been up here? Out? Alright. Probably play a little bit longer here. Oh my god, I did not realize rain, wet, and trees make you really, really tired. Goodness. And play this. Anyone have any fun plans for this weekend? And I apologize if I'm not very talkative like I was Wednesday. Just tired. Oh boy. Okay. Who all do we have coming with? 7, 100, back check. Nah, what are you? 7, 8, alright. We should be alright here. There are two already, so I do have to keep that in mind. I'm gonna try and motivate these guys to keep pushing up. I'm not lit yet. Yep, there it is. And immediately the A button's in hit. I'm not wasting my time. Oh my god, IS-7. I don't even know how you got in my way, but you got in my way. You just give up? Go back. And leave it to Artie. Completely ruined games. Yeah, I'm kind of waiting for WWE to end as well. I absolutely hate it. I'm gonna need that A button again. God damn, I didn't really want to. That was a big mistake on your part. Nope. Still keeping it. Jesus Christ. Like, did anyone on my team do anything? So I think I'm going to do one more game, and then I'm going to go to bed early, just because I'm so tired. And I need to eat food, too. I forgot I didn't. Yeah. Didn't eat. We were talking about the IS-7 earlier. I think I'm going to go off with that game. Okay, that was the right one. Alright. What's up, Robert? You tuned in just in time for, like, the last game to start. We have started. How are you doing? Hopefully you're doing okay. And for anyone just now joining us, don't worry. I think I might stream tomorrow. Maybe. Depends on if I actually end up going somewhere tomorrow. Although weather seems like it does not want to. The shot. Grind for an IS-7? forward to learning something. Well, I'm glad you are learning. I'm glad you enjoy learning things here. There are plenty to learn. Haha, that's right. Valor, oh god. Ah, shit. Okay. This dumb, stupid thing is still sitting there. Do it again. Do it again. I dare you. No. Alright. Well, I'm gonna literally say... Hey, I just had a massive lag spike. Robert, if that was you that just sent me a party invite, I hate to say it, but I really do need to decline that because I'm going to bed after this. Is it early? Yes, but after being in pouring rain for a good amount of hours, soaked head to toe, covered in sawdust and absolutely miserable, and on top of that, didn't even get to finish my lunch. Yeah. I am exhausted, and I did say I'd need to go eat something, so I'm probably going to go eat something, then go straight to bed, because good God, I am hungry. But yeah, if you have a question or something, man, feel free to send me a message on it, and I can, you killed you so, good job, team, excellent job. You guys literally did nothing at all to contribute. I think the Artie is the only one that actually contributed anything. Let's see. Let's see, was it the Artie that contributed something? No, it was the E5 that contributed something. Everyone else did horrible. Where the hell am I on this? Oh, there I am. Because apparently this guy did better than me. Yeah, there you go, that makes sense. Alright. Okay, so just a couple of admin things here real quick. Just real quick admin things. This weekend, you know, I know that a lot of people aren't really big fans of these things, but I do have another user-submitted replay that I need to put out because I told them that I was going to. And I kind of procrastinated on trying to space those out as long as I could because now he's asking about it. Because he wants to clear it off his DVR, so he's asking if I plan on using it anytime soon. So this weekend's video is another map awareness video, and then I'm going to try and work on a collaboration with Turkey for next weekend's video. And then there's going to be two more videos out, pretty much a total of three videos are going to be this weekend, which is why I'm doing a map awareness, because I don't have time to be fucking around with three different videos for hours on end. I got a bunch of other stuff I have to do. So it's going to be a map awareness video. I'm going to redo redo my intro. So no need to really watch that. But hey, if you want to watch it anyway and take a look at the change from when I first started, feel free. And then this month's QA vid is going to come out this weekend as well. So if anyone has any interest in that, you know, look out for that as well. So three videos this weekend. Apologize if one of them really isn't what you want in terms of content, but I need to be able to edit three videos. So yeah, other than that, I really want to thank everyone for stopping and hanging out with me and putting up with my fits of annoyance and anger and being hangry. And I think there's something called tingry, like, you know, you're tired and angry. I don't know. I think that's a thing. But other than that, I might try and stream tomorrow as well if I have time or if the weather keeps me home. But thank you all again for hanging out with me, and have a good weekend. Stay healthy, and may the games be in your favor, unlike they were for me. So I'm going to end it at that. Have a good evening, everyone.